people who are HIV positive deal with so much stress of having to take medicine, going to doctor's appointments, and on top of that, having to deal with stereotypes. Because of stereotypes, HIV positive patients might not be able to have friends, healthy relationships with their families, or having a relationship with a partner. There has been HIV positive patients who have been able to feel the love of having a relationship and being able to be with someone who won't judge them because they have HIV.
If I had unlimited access to money and power to create services and support for people living with HIV and AIDS, I would use the money and power. I could open a recreational center whereby I could announce an opening of a gym whereby infected people could come and exercise, and I could sometimes arrange meetings with the community and encourage affected and infected people about HIV and AIDS and give pamphlets to the people.
As a young teen and preteen, I will hear my fellow schoolmates clown about HIV. Hearing kids my age already having sex partners and his friends would say, "Watching you get AIDS, haha, you better not come near me." I never knew what it was, but hearing that made me know AIDS, HIV were diseases you catch from having sex, and it's contagious if you're near a person. HIV/AIDS are contagious only from breast milk, vagina fluids, and sperm. I heard that many people, not only teens, were scared to take a test, so they hide in their shell like a snail being scared.
I will persuade people that being near a person with HIV will not give them HIV unless they get their blood on them. I can imagine seeing people going around telling other people the same thing, and from there on, no one will be putting down on others for having HIV. Everyone will be supporting each other, and everyone will feel good.
The stereotypes I heard were that people with HIV are like creepy monsters that eat your soul or something like that. That seems more like just a myth. I guess a stereotype would be like the person with HIV is automatically a homosexual, which isn't always true. I know that many people are indeed heterosexual that have contracted the virus. I know people are afraid to get tested because they are afraid of being too embarrassed, so they don't get tested. I tell myself the real ways that HIV is transmitted and not be afraid of the myths that people say or about contracting HIV.
It is a myth. If you are HIV positive and sleep with a virgin, then your HIV will go away. If you are HIV positive, then you cannot have kids. People treated HIV positive people like snakes, thinking if you get close enough, you will die.
People with HIV face a lot of stereotypes. They are rejected by the people around them. And as ridiculous as it sounds, most people don't ever want to be seen around people with HIV. They do not want to touch them or kiss them or even love them. All the advice in the world has been given to encourage people to get tested and disclose their status. So there really isn't anything new that I'd say. What's important is that you realize that you're doing it for yourself, and by knowing your status, you can choose an appropriate lifestyle for yourself. All that is important is taking good care of yourself so you can live a healthy lifestyle.
I did not know much about HIV/AIDS before. There were rumors that gay men had it. That was probably one of the biggest stereotypes. Although it was sometimes true, it applies to others as well, like women and children. You would get this if you changed fluids like blood or had unprotected sex with someone that has it. There was a rumor if you had sex with someone or multiple women, you would not have it anymore. So this made more people sick and infected. A lot of people are afraid to share out. People would try to change the subject or just joke about it. One person took a lot of courage, like a brave person does, and told their story to one of their friends.
I started seeing that on TV. They would show a gay person having a good time, then him sick somewhere, saying that he should have been more responsible.
People are afraid of having to be all alone because nobody wants to get infected. Because of the many myths about HIV, people refuse to take tests to see if they are HIV positive, afraid of being alone, not being able to fit in with the others.
I heard about getting HIV from kissing, about blue waffles, or just dying right after. They might not want to know the truth, or just scared of going alone, scared of losing their friends and family, and scared of themselves. I would tell them the consequences, about how longer you would take, the worse it would get. I would go with them, I would tell them the whole procedure so they won't be afraid.
A myth that I have heard about the HIV and AIDS prevention is that if a person is infected with HIV, him or her can be cured by traditional healers, and also if that person is infected with HIV can also get healed by having sex with a virgin. Some reasons are that if they get tested, people will isolate them because they say HIV people must not live with people who are not HIV positive. And another reason is if people in the community know that someone is infected with HIV, they neglect and traumatize them because ARVs are now used as drugs.